Spot Kota Tua. Let's check it out.
Hello friends, let's start with the first museum, the Wayang Museum. The Wayang Museum was inaugurated for its use and designation as a museum on August 13, 1975. This museum is still in the Old City Tourist Area, and of course, the area is very close to the Jakarta History Museum, precisely on Jalan Pintu Besar Utara, number 27. To enter to the museum, we are encouraged to scan the barcode on the account Peduli Lindungi or show a vaccination card. After the scan, we will be checked for temperature using the tools provided and show the card that has been purchased to get an entrance ticket. At the beginning of entering, we will see a large puppet statue, namely the puppet Gatot Kaca and Pergiwa. On the first floor, there are various kinds of statues and puppets, such as statues of Rama and Laksamana, statues of Hanuman, puppet Bandung, West Java, Rama Wijaya, and puppet statues that tell serials, such as the Ramayana series, and etc. This one statue is named Tembikar Semar from Cirebon. Pottery, this tembikar in the past worked as a tool to save money or saving. This is a blencong lamp from East Nusa Tenggara. This lamp is in the form of a white boar, which is a means of lighting wayang kulit performance at night. Beside it is a puppet that tells the scan in the Dandeka Forest. And this is a big puppet, the name is Semar. Okay friends, let's go to the next place. In this place, there are dolls like the Gale Gale doll and various puppets. Well, here there are also puppets that tell legends such as the story of the Sweet Ancol Bridge and Lenong Jakarta. On the second floor, there are many kinds of puppet from various regions, such as Betawi puppet, cardboard puppet, and Surakarta puppet. Then, there is the puppet revolution. This puppet describes the formation of puppet from the time of the palace until the era of independence. Not only telling stories of legends, here there are also puppets that tell fable stories, like puppet that tells the deer.
Next observation is Sokal Museum, namely the History Museum or what is commonly called the Fathahillah Museum. This museum was inaugurated on the 30th of March 1974 by the Governor Ali Sadikin. This museum collects 23,500 historical objects. At the entrance, we immediately see a mural room that tells of life in the Dutch colonial period. next to the Diponegoro room. On the first floor, we will see a woman's prison where at the time, our hero from Aceh named Chutnyadin was tied here. On the second floor, there are writings, one of which is a Pinoman painting and also a Hayalisi painting which depicts the Diponegoro wife Letoningsi and also his son Ali Basya. This is company batik. This batik cloth is specially made by Damar Hadi for Diponegoro room. Here there is a room used by a national hero namely Prince Diponegoro. Right beside this bed there is a table where there is a letter written by Diponegoro to his mother and elder son. This is Sudataruma Negara. Here there are stones like Durga Kali from Tanjung Priok and Ganesha from a butcher stall Sunday market. And here there is Wisnu Cibuaya 1 and Wisnu Cibuaya 2. This is a monument inscription found in the Tugu village area, North Jakarta. And this is the Ciaratan inscription found in the downstream Ciaratan village, River Bogor district. This is the Cuban copy inscription which was found not far from the location where the inscription was found. This is a period of farming market by the emergence of the ability to grow crops and tame animals. In this chamber there are peristyle objects from the Neolithic era consisting of pickaxes, stone chips and much more. And there are miniatures, such as miniature of care and storage box and container for rice kale and set of weights and much more. This is an Omaladen village. This Omaladen village is an area outside the control of the Netherlands and is a part of Batavia. This is a painting of Bandanera, a small group of islands that were fought over by the British and the Dutch in the peace treaty in the 1585 until 1620 period. When we come out of the museum, we will see the dungeon. During Dutch as English government, this building was a place for execution of the death penalty. And thousands of Chinese people and a rebel named Peter Elberfeld and his comrade died here.
Terima kasih atas waktunya. Sekian, terima kasih. Wassalam.